One of the biggest points of resistance that I hear from people when they're thinking about hiring a virtual assistant is how in the world to go about training that person. So many people don't really have systems built into their business. They don't really know what they're doing from one day to the next. So how on earth are you supposed to bring a new person into the business and sort all of that out? Soon as you think about it, you might just say, later, let me just table that until later. But at some point, we got to face the music and address it. And you'll be happy to know that it is not as complicated as you may think it is. Before I go any further, let me make sure and point out jenlaner.com/VA resources. There's a ton of materials there to help you in your search and training and day-to-day operations with a virtual assistant. I still remember a really huge moment in my business with my virtual assistant, Neeca. So she's been with me about 6 years now. And this was very early on. And we were chatting about my website and she referred to it as our website. So maybe she said something like, "Hey, Jen, I think we need to fix the pop-up on our website." Hearing her say our business told me that she really saw this position as really important, that she felt like she was part of this business. So I wasn't sure exactly what I was doing right, but I knew something was going right. And when I heard that, I really wanted to cry because for the first time, I felt like I had real support in my business. So in order to get to that point, you definitely do need to do a little bit of preparation in advance. So we're going to talk about that. So if you're new around here, my name is Jen Lehner, and I have helped hundreds of solo professionals, solopreneurs, coaches, course creators, authors, small business people to scale their business significantly by outsourcing the smart way. And today I'm going to show you how to get off on the right foot with your virtual assistant. Number one, upon hiring, you want to have an agreement. Now, the truth is, if you're hiring somebody from the Philippines, this agreement, contractually, legally speaking, isn't worth a lot. I mean, because if somebody violates the agreement, what are you going to do, right? Like they're in the Philippines, you're not going to go to court. However, it's just a really good idea to literally be on the same page and set those expectations right from the very beginning in this agreement. On day one, you want to welcome your VA properly. And we like to do this on Mondays to be their start day because, you know, Monday's the obvious day for a new person to start. But also that's when we have our team meetings. So we invite our new VA into our team meetings. We do these on either on Zoom or on Google Hangouts. And we just introduce them to the team. Usually they don't stay for the whole meeting. That will happen in this, you know, in the following weeks, but they join us for the first team meeting so that they can meet everyone. And if it's just you, same thing, jump on a quick call to formally welcome your new virtual assistant. Next, you want to have a sort of control panel for your new virtual assistant, a dashboard. What this is some place where you can collaborate. And if you've been following my channel for a while, you know that I'm a huge fan of Trello, but you could do this on a Google Doc. You could do this in Google Drive. You could do this in Asana. Really doesn't matter. You just want to choose a tool that allows you to collaborate and put stuff up into the cloud. So we like to use a Trello board that welcomes the new VA. So when they land on the Trello board, they're going to see start here. And at that point, they're going to see a welcome message. Then it's a good idea to have another video that takes them on a tour of your business. So even if, let's say you're not a virtual business, let's say you have an actual brick and mortar store, you can get your iPhone and just walk around your store and say, "This is our front door. This is our break room. This is how we open the register." You know, show them around. Same thing for a virtual business. You would record your screen. I'm going to show you how to do that in a minute. You record your screen and you could say, "These are all of our products. This is our YouTube channel. This is our Facebook page." So take them on a tour of all the things. And then I like having a video that is more, it goes a little deeper into what are your goals? What is your culture? What are your beliefs? What does success look like in your business? What are you trying to project to your audience? We go as far as to say things like, you know, our brand is very polished. We don't like things to look fussy. So we talk about the physical look of our brand. We share our branding, our brand board, our colors, our logos, our fonts. But we also say that we want to be perceived by our audience as no fluff, as reliable, as fun, that sort of thing. Lighthearted, but trustworthy, you know, that we expect excellence. So that means we strive to have, you know, no typos, and so on and so forth. But so what is it? This gives you an opportunity to really pause for a moment and think about, like, what is your why? What do you want to accomplish? What is your vibe like in your business? What are you trying to convey? How do you want people to feel when they interact with your brand? These are all wonderful things to put into a video welcoming your new virtual assistant. And by the way, this doesn't have to be a fancy video. This doesn't have to be edited in any way. Doesn't have to have an intro and an outro. You're just going to use this tool that I'm going to show you next. Hello, down here in the corner. This is kind of meta because this is a Loom video. That is, I'm using Loom to create a video about Loom. And this is hands down the best screen recording software on the market. I could say that confidently because I have tried them all. They do have a free version that you can use to try out, but this is basically how it works. So you'll see like this little blue star up in the corner. When you click on that, it begins recording your screen, or you can have it record just your face, in which case, like my face would be the only thing that you would see on the screen. It would be real big on the screen, or you could do your face and the screen, which is of course what we're doing right now. And we can even like move this little doohickey around now. And over the years, they've added so many cool features to Loom. I'm not going to go into it, but bottom line is, wonderful tool to use to not just welcome your VA, but to communicate with your VA every day. We use Loom often. So this is what you would use to record, to give your VA a tour of your business, your Google Drive, whatever it is they need to see, and also to welcome them into your business and to tell them about the culture of your business and to set expectations and all that good stuff. Next step is to identify any tasks that you do in your business currently on a daily basis, a weekly basis, a monthly basis, quarterly basis, and randomly, like just every so often. Okay. Start to look at all the tasks in your business and separate them out in that fashion. What do you do every day? What do you do every week? Then you want to create lists on your Trello board that also divvy up tasks that way. And then you simply are going to add trainings that relate to those specific tasks in those columns. Now, here's a little bit of magic. If you record a video of you working through a process in your business, it might be the way that you create an invoice, or the way you onboard a new client, or the way that you like to create a graphic in canva.com. It could be any of that. You're simply going to use Loom Video to record that, and you're going to put it on the Trello board. But one of the first things you can ask your VA to do is to create a checklist, to create a system of that task. And what does that look like? Well, simply a checklist on the Trello board itself, and you can ask them to create perhaps a document if that's going to help, like with screenshots and arrows that say, click here, do this next, because now not only does your VA know how to do this task, but your VA has created a system so that the next person who comes into your business will have access to and can do the task without you having to show them how to do the task. Next, what if you're not good at a lot of things that need to get done in your business? You may not have a clue how to do Google Analytics or how to use Pinterest or so many of the things that we know are good ideas to implement in our business. We just don't know how to do them. Well, guess what? You don't have to know how to do them to train a virtual assistant. In this world where information is so cheap, we've got information everywhere from YouTube trainings to courses at Udemy and Coursera. There's no shortage of information. Wouldn't you agree? Well, you can purchase an inexpensive course. For example, let's say it's on Pinterest. We did this recently in my own business. I purchased a really good Pinterest course and I handed that over to my virtual assistant and said, will you please watch this course? Bring back what you've learned to our team meeting, share how we might implement this in our business. And once we worked out how we were going to use these trainings and these teachings in our business, the things that we wanted to implement, then I asked that VA to create a system for our Pinterest activities in our business. I have absolutely nothing to do with it. And our Pinterest activity is solid. Everything we're doing on Pinterest, we have a plan. Our Pinterest audience is growing and I didn't have to teach it. My last tip is to consider scheduling a half day or full VIP day with your virtual assistant. This goes a long way in showing your VA that you really are invested in him or her. And it gives you an opportunity to really catch your breath and discuss anything that might have been missed in the initial onboarding process and to really develop your ideas more fully, to really explain the big picture, where you want things to go, what your expectations are, and sort of helping to set the vision of your business with your virtual assistant. Because again, around here, we're not interested in fly-by-night contractors who come in and out of our business. We're interested in developing long-term, meaningful relationships where our virtual assistants grow with our business as partners who have a sense of ownership in the business. And that makes all the difference. So if you want to learn more about this, I have tons of free resources, as I said in the beginning, at jenlehner.com/VA resources. Also, I've got a wonderful downloadable PDF. I think you're going to love it. It's 160 tasks that you can delegate to your virtual assistant. And finally, I have a free training coming up called Solopreneur to CEO Secrets. It is a workshop that is all about hiring your perfect match virtual assistant. And you can get there by going to ceosecretstraining.com and join us. I hope you found these tips handy for training your virtual assistant. Remember to like and subscribe and hit that little bell so you are always notified whenever I upload a new training. See you next time.